Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Hopefully you guys can hear me. I have been getting notified for the past week that the mic kind of goes in and out. I just got notified today, or I just figured out today that this mic kind of goes in and out. It works, and then sometimes it doesn't. So hopefully you can hear me very well. Also, don't mind the background. I'm rearranging some things around in my room, so for right now, this is just what it's looking like for right now. Until we can get some things sorted out and situated to sort it out. Okay. So, if you're new here, hi, my name is V. If you're accustomed to being here, then you know how this goes. You know who I am, and you know why I'm here. I did want to do a first quarter of 2024 reading, which is going to consist of the first 3 months, so it'll be January, February, March. I am doing 2024 over yearly readings on the website. It's $105, but I know that times are hard, shit is expensive, so I do have Shop Pay available for $26.25 for installments of $26.25. So that is available, of course, drop down below in the description box for everything else that you might need. Yes, I keep checking my phone, so I'm going to lock it and throw it to the side so I won't get distracted. And is there anything else? Is that everything? I think that's everything. So let's go ahead and go to the oracle card, and then I'll jump in with the tarot, and we'll go from there. So, Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus people, what do they need to know? The Rose's Kiss is what fell out, so I'm going to take it. These oral cards have been slowly sliding out. I did Aquarius before y'all, and Aquarius is also kind of just like slid out. So, the Rose's Kiss is the card that you guys have. It says, connecting with nature, enjoying sensual pleasures of sex, and being aware of the sensations of taste, touch, sight, smell, sound might be important right now. How do your sheets feel? Can you reach out and feel the heat or the softness of your companion, and will nestle next to you? Be present to another person, see them, and let yourself be seen. Your five senses are aching to be engaged right now. This is an invitation to get out of your head and into your body. You may be a spiritual and intelligent being, but for right now, the emphasis should be on having a sensory experience. This is all a sacred part of the gift of life. By being present in the sensual world, you invite yourself to a deeper spiritual experience. Amazing, isn't it? Perhaps it really is time to stop and kiss the roses. That's, wow, okay. It's so interesting. Is why I love tarot, why I love doing what I do, because the roses kiss is one thing, but stopping and smelling the roses is basically the message of this card. But not to just smell it, but kiss it. That is also a very interesting thing. I've never heard nobody say maybe it really is time to stop and kiss the roses. Anyway, there's a ladybug on this card, which I think is good luck. Of course, I don't know if you grew up in the South as a little black girl like me, but ladybugs are good luck. So this is also a card of good luck. I feel like you're coming into some good luck, some good energy, Sagittarius, when it comes to the first quarter of 2024. Bottom of the deck, you have great and full. So this is a time to make sure that you are being grateful for what is, okay? When you show gratitude and you're grateful for what you have, it accumulates more. If you spend a lot of your time thinking about what you don't have, thinking about what you wish you would have, thinking about lack, then that's all that you manifest, right? That is the power of co-creation. I don't know who needed to hear that message, but there you go. That is the power of co-creation. The longer you stay and focus on what you don't have, the money you don't have, the love you don't have, the life you don't have, the car you don't have, the longer you spend time focusing on what you don't have, and that is what you co-create into your reality. Because what you focus on is what you manifest. Right? So as long as you're staying grateful, and staying optimistic to what's to come, you bring in more good shit, right? I was telling somebody that last week when they got this card. It's like, damn, if you busting your ass for $500 or for, yeah, let's say you busting your ass for $500. Let's say you make 50, right? It's really easy to focus on the lack thereof, right? It's very easy to focus on that $450 you didn't get, but it, as a opposed to that $50 that you got, right? But staying in a grateful energy to say, God, I'm thankful for this $50, because at least this $50 can get me a pack of chicken or put some gas in my car. You leave yourself susceptible for more blessings. But the more you sit here and you harbor on like that, I only made $50, then that's what you keep, right? Moving on to this, getting out of your head for the first quarter of the year is going to be very beneficial to you. Okay. Sensuality in the five senses isn't just reduced down to the mundane, right? In the grand scheme of things, what this card is asking for you to do is to, like it said, get out of your head and get into your body, regardless of what that means to you. Indulging in the five senses can look like anything. Indulging in the five senses can look like anything. One of my favorite things to do that's helped me get out of my head and get into my body, especially this year in 2023, was getting into the gym. If there was nothing that got me into my body like anything else, it was the gym. Because when you're focusing on the reps and you're focusing on like the aching of your muscles, how do you have time to think about anything else? You're not stressing about rent. Because you're thinking about this goddamn 110 that's on your calf muscles right now. You know what I'm saying? Spend the first quarter of the year trying to indulge things like that to have a well-rounded experience, right? Like the book said, yeah, you can be spiritual. Yeah, you can be an intellectual. Anybody can be those two, right? But how often are you indulging in the five senses? When's the last time you bought you some good quality sheets, right? When's the last time you just bought a nice smell good candle and just smelled the aroma and just enjoyed the luxury of that aroma? When's the last time you had a good meal, or you made a good meal, or you cooked a good meal, or even if you ate one, even if you're watching this and you're like, "B girl, I can't cook to save my life to the first." Okay, well then, how your mama cook it? How your granny cook it? How your aunties cook it? How your sister cook, brother, uncles cook it? When's the last time you had a good meal? When's the last time you watched something beautiful, or seen something beautiful, went to an art show, watched the sunset? Right? What have you been listening to that actually feeds the soul? Not just music that you like and it makes your leg tap, but it really does feed the soul. It doesn't even have to be music, right? So these are the things that we need to be focusing on. Remember to stop and smell the roses, especially with the hustle and bustle of life, right? Like I said, I feel like y'all got some good stuff coming towards y'all, right? As long as you're being grateful. Even with this cup, right? You see something coming out of it. That cup running over. So you have a lot of stuff coming. So it's going to be important to you, Sagittarius, to make sure that you're getting out of your head and out of the hustle and bustle of life and into your body, into your senses. Go to the gym. Stop and smell the roses. Shit, buy you some roses. Put them bitches on the kitchen counter in the vase or something like that. But do something nice for yourself in the midst of everything that you're doing. Because again, you can get so wrapped up in the lack of it all, or you can get so wrapped up in the hustle and bustle of it all, the money, the hustle, the life, the career, the bills, the performance, the entertainment of it all, that you forget that you are a human being. Give me some tarot cards for what Sagittarius can expect. Yeah, King of Pentacles, the World card, Ten of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles. A lot of good, y'all have some good money coming in, Sagittarius. I know that's right. Now, what do y'all got to stop and smell the roses card? Because y'all gonna be focused on this motherfucking abundance. That's what it's giving me. Y'all is focused on this abundance. Look at this eye. Look at this eye. It made me feel like he was staring straight at me. So I feel like y'all have y'all eye on the prize in 2024. Y'all head on straight. Y'all ain't even worried about nothing. Y'all coming into 2024 with a plan. Look at the Lover's card. Y'all are coming into 2024 with a plan. Y'all are coming into it with a plan. Y'all are closing out cycles with this World card. All these pentacles. Y'all could be penny pinching right now. Money could seem a little tight, especially with the holidays. And Christmas and New Year. So money could be pretty tight if y'all had a lot of people to pay for. But I'm seeing some good shit, Sagittarius. I'm also getting, Masculine energies. I don't know. I feel like I've always got some masculines watching. If you got some Earth in your chart, or maybe some Gemini in your chart. If you got Gemini, if you got some Earth in your chart, I would even so much as say a fixed sign, because this world card is giving me fixed sign. So let's say if you were Sagittarius with Earth in your chart, Aries, not Aries, yes, actually. Let's say you're Sagittarius with Earth in your chart, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, or a fixed sign energy. So that's emphasis on Taurus, because Taurus is Earth fixed sign. Taurus, Leo, Aquarius, Scorpio. I know why I'm having a brain fart right now. Or if you have Gemini in your chart. I'm seeing especially those with Earth in their chart, especially. Whoever had their hand out, whoever got their hand out, I see you wrapping up that cycle in 2024, or it needs to be. If you allow a lot of people to pull on you, whether it be financially, energetically, maybe they just constantly always need you, put a lot of burden or responsibility or something like that on you, you either need to be wrapping up the cycle in the first quarter of 2024, or you will be. For a lot of you, where that applies, I'm seeing you wrapping it up because there's somebody you like. This Lover's card is giving me, you got your eye on someone, especially with this Lover's and this Ten of Pentacles right here. So I feel like, yeah, for a lot of you, y'all got your eye on somebody that you like, a crush or something. And I'm seeing whoever been pulling on you, you're about to make that shit stop before you can continue in 2024, because you got your eye on somebody that you are trying to do something with. Aside from that, let's say you just have Gemini in your chart. I feel like if you have Sagittarius with Gemini in your chart, I feel like this is your family. The Lover's card, you love your family, right? But I feel like you're understanding and hitting a pinnacle now with your family, not about to make you broke, right? Whereas, like, I'm grateful for them. I'm grateful for the ability to be able to provide and help. But they're not about to keep pulling on me. Yeah, and for others of you, I'm seeing, especially like fixed Earth energy, I'm kind of seeing it over here. You've probably allowed your family to pull on you enough, and I'm kind of getting a big energy of, okay, after this Thanksgiving, I mean, or after this Christmas, it probably, maybe could have been around Thanksgiving, Christmas. Because I don't know why I said Thanksgiving, I wasn't trying to say that. So maybe it was around Thanksgiving, Christmas, when you're like, look, y'all got Thanksgiving, Christmas, and next year, that shit dead. Y'all been not asking me, nobody been not asking me for nothing. And I feel like, again, that's why it's like, hey, remember to stop and smell the roses, right? You might come into January, February, March ready to hit it. You ready to hit it. You ready to make money. You ready to have your cup running over. You tired of penny pinching. You know what I'm saying? You feel like you stuck between a rock and a hard place, because that's that kind of vibe. Yeah, even up under that, you have the Seven of Pentacles with the Devil card. Yeah, a lot of y'all been attached to something or somebody, and you got some good news coming in. You about to stop. Because it's looking like you got somebody else you want to be pouring into. So I'm getting good feelings, good energy from y'all, Sagittarius. Masculine energies could have someone, a special someone they want to pour into. This Lover's card could also be, again, maybe your friends, or pouring into your own stuff. I'm getting Taurus very heavy, too. I don't know why I'm seeing, because there's that bull for Taurus. Y'all see it. There's that bull for Taurus, and then there's Taurus again right here. So yeah, very much Taurus. You could be a Sagittarius or some Taurus, dealing with a Taurus, cross-watching for a Taurus, or a Taurus cross-watching for a Sagittarius or something. Somebody's been stuck in some sort of something where you kind of feel stuck between a rock and a hard place. You can't really invest in where you want to invest into because you invest in that other shit. It's still like family. So yeah, I feel like regardless of if it's family, friends of a friend's friends of a family, family of a friend, or however, whatever, whoever, wherever, I feel like y'all are definitely wrapping that shit up. I feel like you have your own family that you want to tend to with this King of Pentacles and this Ten of Pentacles. I'm seeing financial abundance for y'all, Sagittarius. I'm also seeing that love will also be really, really good for y'all, Sagittarius, for a few of you. Money and love will be really, really good. I feel like a love connection will even be stabilizing. I'm hearing stabilizing with this Nine of Pentacles. So I feel like a connection will either be stabilizing, or you or someone pertaining to you is about to start doing what needs to be done. Sagittarius, it's for like y'all though, I'm sorry. It does. If this isn't love related, this is work related, and again, don't let your friends pull on you or people who feel like friends. For masculine energies, it's still more romance related. Like, okay, I'm about to cut off anything that's pulling on me or fucking with me from pouring into my abundance so I can get the person that I chose. You see this arrow? He got two women on his side, but there's an arrow pointing to one of them. So somebody already know who they choose. But for others of you where, like, this is a, like, a, my feminine Sagittarius, I feel like you expect for a lot of people to have their hands out. I feel like you're going to make a lot of your money, and I feel like you can expect for a lot of people to have their hands out. And I feel like for a lot of you, you're about to wrap up that cycle too, whereas we're like, you're the breadwinner, Sagittarius. This could be your own thing. You could be going so hard during the first quarter of the year to where your own family is like, ooh, girl, let me hold some. And you're going to be like, ain't got it. Right, but just make sure that you, I feel like that with all of these pentacles, a big, big, big thing for y'all is making sure that you are stopping to enhance and indulge in five senses. Don't be so in your head thinking about what's going to happen 5 years from now. Don't be so in your head thinking about what happened 5 years ago. Don't be so in your head thinking and trying to be so spiritual and so smart and brainiac that you forget to simply just indulge in your pleasures. I don't give a fuck if it's a little sex. I don't give a fuck if it's a little smoking. I don't give whatever it is, right? Don't overindulge. But don't be so focused on all this money and finance and pentacle and stability that you forget to do the small stuff like stop and smell the roses. If you've gotten this far, thank you. I deeply appreciate it. If this resonated with you, definitely leave me some thumbs up or some comments down below in the description box. If you want a personalized 2024 reading, you can definitely book one. Again, the price is on my website. Shop Pay is available if you are balling on a budget. Thank you again so much for checking out my channel. Definitely subscribe. Check down below in the description box for anything else you might need outside of the website that you might want to know about me. And